Welcome to NewPointe Online. My name is Aaron, and I'm the Worship Experience Director at the Canton Campus. We want you to know that this online service has been built with you in mind. So whenever, wherever, or however you're watching, welcome. We hope that something you see today really impacts you and inspires you to take your next step. We are so excited you're here. Let's get started.
Do you your mental health is an ocean, then your emotional health is the waves. Rising and falling as the moments pass, being pushed and pulled by the storms above and the ships that cut through them. Churning and swelling in every joyous celebration, cresting and crashing in every uncomfortable distress, and yet calm and serene in all the moments of rest and relaxation. Our lives are ever-changing and constant, so how do we learn to move with the currents of our emotions so we don't drown in the depths of our mind? How can we float above the constant movement of the sea that we all swim in? Because something new is always on its way, and it comes in waves.
Hey, it's been said that if you don't diagnose the problem right, you'll never get the prescription right. And so that is true with your life and in my life. We all must be clear about how we have been wounded. And if we're not, we will struggle with our relationship with God, and we will struggle with our relationship with others. Now, we're wrapping up this series, It Comes in Waves. And what we've said is that emotional health is the software, the mental health is the hardware. And the mental health is the ocean, and the emotional health are the waves that hit us. And we've all been hit by that, and which means that we've all experienced pain. And if we don't examine our pain, an unexamined pain can rule your life and my life. And we can ignore it, but if we ignore it, what happens is we will adjust our life to the pain, and we won't be living the life that God wants us to live. We'll be living a different life. Now, too many of us, okay, have been living the life adjusted to our pain instead of working through our pain and our hurt. And if you're going to be emotionally healthy, if you're going to be mentally strong, you need to be able to deal with that. You see, undealt wounds causes us to go through life out of sync. And our relationships are out of sync. And our life is not all that God wants it to be, because we just don't function well. And that means that we don't experience every good thing that God has for you and me. And so we need to be able to identify those wounds, not to fix blame, not to provide excuses, but to be able to approach it in a healthy way. Now, what are those things that we need to be aware of, okay? Well, usually wounds come in our life in two different ways, and we need to be wise in how we handle these wounds so that what happens is we can experience the transformation that God has for us. And these wounds basically come in two ways. First of all, wounds of commission. Wounds of commission. Wounds of commission, this is something that has been done to us. It's been done to you and I through another person. It might include verbal abuse, physical abuse, sexual abuse. It might include abandonment. It might include betrayal. It might include rejection. But these are wounds of commission. This is where somebody has intentionally done something to you or to me to harm us. Now, the second type of wounds are wounds of omission, okay? This happens through something that has been omitted in your life. Maybe the absence of a parent or the loss of something rather than a purposeful act, and yet it can be just as damaging and just as hurtful and painful. And so we have to understand that if we're going to be able to be healthy emotionally and mentally, that we're going to have to be able to identify the wounds of commission and the wounds of omission. Now, what are the damages of the wounds of commission? Well, you know what? You might need to ask God to reveal that, because maybe you've pushed it aside for so long that you've ignored it and you've numbed it, and you need to come back and you need to say, God, you know, help me with this. And one of the ways in which you can do that is ask yourself this question: what are the three most significant things that have shaped my life? You know, over the past 20 years, over the past 15 years, over the past 30, however old you are, what are the three most significant things that have shaped my life? And if they're wounds, okay, think about the lies that have taken root there. Because here's what I know. Whenever you and I are wounded, the enemy wants to come in and tells us lies because he wants to hold you captive. And so you want to be able to do that with wounds of commission. And you might say, well, what about wounds of omission? Well, we have to be wise about these as well, because what happens is wounds of omission, as I said, are just as painful as wounds of commission. And so we need to be able to examine our life, and we need to be able to say, what was it in life that I really didn't get enough of? All right? That's okay. Now, we're not throwing anybody under the bus. I'm not asking you to throw your mom or your dad under the bus. But maybe growing up, there were some things that you didn't get or you didn't get enough of. You have to be able to identify that. Otherwise, you will try to, listen to me, you will try to fulfill those as an adult. And the needs that you didn't get as a child, you might be 35 years old and trying to find those needs. And that'll lead to an unhealthy, unproductive life. Now, how do we do that, okay? How do we assess the wounds of commission, okay? Let me give you three sources. One is, I already mentioned, ask God. It's the Spirit of God. Ask God, God, reveal to me, are there wounds in my life that I've not dealt with? Are there hurts in my life that I've not dealt with? Secondly, through the Word of God, just by reading and just saying, God, as I read your Word, may you reveal to me areas of my life that I haven't dealt with. And then the third way is through the people of God. See, here's what I know. The people around you, they know you, and they understand why you act a certain way and why you do this and why you don't do that. And so maybe, you know, this is why we believe that groups are so important. It's because you need somebody who knows you, who can help you, and to be able to be a friend to you. And so you want to be able to invite the Spirit of God. You want to be able to read the Word of God. And then you want to be able to have the people of God to speak to you. And I promise you, if you'll do those three things, what will happen will be you will begin to identify if there's any wounds of commission in your life. Now, what about the wounds of omission? How do you know about the wounds of omission? It comes in this form: discontentment. So let me ask you a question. Where are you discontent? Because what happens is when you have wounds of omission in your life, it's those areas that you can never get enough of. Your spouse can never love you enough. You know, your mom and dad can never get it right enough. Whatever those areas are that, you know what, you just have a deep, deep thirst for, and there's always a discontentment there because it's never enough. There's likelihood that you have a wound of omission there. And so it's very, very critical for you and I, if we're going to experience wholeness, if we're going to experience healing, if we're going to experience freedom, to be able to come back and get the diagnosis right. And that is, how have I been wounded? Maybe through wounds of commission, maybe wounds through omission, things that have been omitted or absent in my life. And if you will do that, it's hard, it's difficult. You know what? It's even painful. But I'm telling you, it's worth it. Now, here's what I want to leave you with. Apart from Jesus Christ, though, you'll never experience wholeness. You can go to all the counseling you want in the world, okay? You can go to all the treatments that you want to in the world. Apart from Jesus Christ, you will never experience wholeness and you'll never experience complete healing. You say, why, Dwight? Because he's the one who created you. He's the one who understands your hurts, your habits, and your hangups. He's the one who understands how it has impacted you and influenced your life. And here's the good news. He gives you the invitation to come to him and to bring your hurts, to bring your wounds. That's why he died on a cross for you and for me, so that we could experience a wholeness, a healing, a hope that would bring wholeness to you and me. And so if you've never invited Jesus Christ into your heart and into your life, would you do that today? And even tell him the wounds of your life that maybe have happened through somebody or maybe have happened through the omission of what somebody should have given you and they never did. I promise you, you'll never regret it. And if that's you, would you let us know? Would you let us know? Because we would love to be able to help you to take your next step. And by the way, if you'd like to know more about how to deal with the wounds of commission and omission, I want to encourage you to go to our YouTube channel, and Dr. Tammy Smith is being interviewed, and she talks extensively about these two areas. Would you pray with me? God, we thank you today for your love for us. We know that we live with imperfect people. Our parents were imperfect. We're imperfect. Our friends are imperfect. Our spouses are imperfect. And so we know that all of us have experienced some level of wounds of commission and wounds of omission. And yet you are the great healer. And we come to you and we ask that you would bring healing to our hearts and to our souls and to our life so that we can live life to the fullest. Thank you for your provision. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thanks again for joining us. If something you saw today impacted you, we want to invite you to share it with a friend. We're all about next steps here at NewPointe, and that's a great place to start. To see more content like this, please follow us on our social channels and like and subscribe to keep up to date with everything NewPointe. If you made a decision for Jesus today and are ready to take the next step or just need to talk to someone, we'd love to hear about it and be there for you. Feel free to reach out to us through DM, comment below, or by visiting our website at newpointe.org/contact us. This service and the ministry of NewPointe is made possible thanks to the generosity of others. So if you would like to partner with us in inspiring people to follow Jesus, visit newpointe.org/give or download our mobile app and give there. And if you already give, we want to thank you for that. Your generosity is making an incredible impact. Once again, thank you for joining us today. We hope you have a great week, and we can't wait to see you again next time.